we train a lot at ACC, and DOC, it's something like we leave a little bit behind. But I think that it's very, very important to speak about this fundamental. And okay, I want to do a small introduction about this, because all the things I will say, it's my idea on volleyball. So it's not the truth, it's for sure we're gonna speak about. First of all, I would like to say that for me, there's not two different kind of volleyball. Volleyball is one. There's not volleyball for young people and volleyball for senior people. There's not volleyball of low level and volleyball of high level. The volleyball is one. And the only thing that change is the quality of the individual skills of the girls on the guys plays this volleyball. So don't change the quality of the teams we have in the gym, but doesn't change the sport. Okay. So in my idea, when I teach something, I try to teach all the things that the girls, in my case, I work with girls, so I will speak about women volleyball, but okay, maybe it's the same if we speak about men volleyball. All the things that the girls need to develop their own idea of volleyball, the way to play volleyball in the best ways possible. So from the first day they arrive in the gym, I try to teach all the motor skills they need to learn the specific techniques that we need to use after, from 13 years old to 40 years old, from the under 14 to senior team, to national team. And for sure, when we speak about one fundamental, if we, I take the best player in the world, makes the things better than one player that I can meet in my gym. Okay, but it's only because this player has more important skills, physical skills, technical skills, mental skills. Okay, so I have not to change the fundamental. I just need to find the way to teach the things, and after I adapt the things I teach to the people I have in the gym. This is important as introduction, because after we will speak only about high level technique. For me, when I speak about techniques, I speak only about the best level. Also, if I work with people 13 years old, for sure I need time to work. For sure I need a pattern to follow to teach the fundamental to the players. Okay, but in my mind, I never teach something that is useful only for some specific age. If you have some question, please tell me so we can discuss about, because I know sometimes maybe it's strange, but idea is there's not a volleyball that is good for 14 years old people and the volleyball that is good for 20 years old people. I have to teach the things that they need to learn how to play volleyball. Okay.
Coach, I have a question.
Yeah.
You try to teach a high level technique, but in a young age, it's almost impossible to do it.
Yes, I try to teach the young age all the motor skills, not the high level technique, the motor skills they need to learn in the right age the right technique. I mean, every age is characterized from different physical quality. Okay, so when you grow up, you increase your power, you increase your weight, you are taller, okay, you are faster, you are stronger. So you are more coordinated, you have a better synchronization of your movement. Okay, so you are ready to learn something more complicated, something more, some technique that is for more more important for a bigger player, for a high level volleyball. But if you don't learn the right motor skills, where you can learn the motor skills, you will be not able to learn well the new technique when you need to learn. So if you don't learn how to run when you are young, it's very complicated to teach you how to run when you will be 18 years old. Or if you learn a bad way to jump when you are 8, 9, 10, 11 years old, after will be very complicated to change your way to jump. So I think it's okay that every age is characterized for different technique. Okay, for sure, I don't start, for example, in attack with slide the first day that the girls comes inside the gym. But probably I start to teach the motor skills that it's propedeutic to learn the 1 foot jump. Okay? Nego? Okay, so in this idea, so we will find some adaptation based on the level of the player we have in the gym. We adapt the system, we adapt the performance model, but we don't change volleyball. We just do one step back in order to build the best player we can build. Okay, and what is important to about the performance model? What are the set of the features that characterize the performance model? It's the physical characteristics, the technical characteristic, and the tactical characteristics, plus the psychological characteristics that are important also, okay? But for the moment, we leave this part, okay, aside. Okay, so about physical, we said physical characteristics change the way you play volleyball, because when you are very young, you have not enough strength with the ball to jump, to run fast, to move fast. Okay, you are not tall enough to go over the net, probably. But in this moment is the more important moment to learn how to move on the net, for example. Talking about block, okay, for example, we have to learn how to translate on the net. We have to learn how to control our body. We have to learn how to jump when we finish the movement to reach the maximum high, for example. We have to learn how to control our platform, bouncing platform, our hands on block, to be forward in the other side, to be active, to control the ball, to play against high level setter. So we need also to learn how to play against one-on-one against somebody. So again, the setter against the spiker. And all these things we have to build step by step, day by day, from when the girls or the guys or the boys arrive in the gym the first time. Okay. So the other thing that increases the power, more jump, more power in the ball, and more control. So also here, if the power increase, for sure you need to adapt something. If the players are taller, you need to adapt something in your way to block. If the ball of the setter are faster, you need to change something to be faster in block. Okay. All this part helped me to understand the way to choose one strong blocker. In general, the position, the role that is most characterized from the block is the middle blocker. For us, it's very important to understand who can be a good middle blocker. Okay, yes, usually you arrive in the gym, you see a very tall guy, very tall girl, a very tall boy, and you see, okay, you are very tall, you will be middle blocker. But after, we see that he cannot be a middle blocker. So we have to find a way to understand who is a good blocker and who cannot be a good blocker. And my way is absolutely linked with the game. Only play 6-on-6 can help you to understand if somebody can do something or not. My idea is this, more or less. I take one young boy, I put the boy on the net, and in the net, and I say, okay, there is the setter in the other side. The setter set, read the ball. And I want just to understand if he's able to read the ball, to move and to jump in front of the spiker. Without knowing about nothing about technique. So just run behind the ball. Why it's so important for me, this characteristic? Because this characteristic is not only technical characteristic, it's not only related about technique or physical characteristic, it's something that inside have the seed of the quality of the setter, I mean, of the middle blocker. I mean, if one girl is able to read the ball, to move fast and to jump in front of the spiker, it means that she has something special. After, you will work in all the techniques she needs, all the motor skill she needs. But first of all, it's something that she has inside. It's a character, it's a individual characteristic of the player. It's talent. If I need to understand if someone have the talent to do one role, middle blocker, I need to have something to measure this talent. And for me, the thing that give you the weight of the talent is the ability, the capacity to read the ball. Because if you are able to read the ball, it means that you are fast enough to move. You have the coordination between your eyes and your brain, your eyes and your body to understand where the ball will go. You are able to move and you are able to jump. And after, there is the part of hands, the block, blah, 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 blah. But it's something that we will teach. I remember many times in the gym I had young girls that are very good in block without doing nothing. It was only talent. And is the thing that we need. Okay, so my idea is, okay, how I can understand if someone is good or not for the disposition to be a middle blocker. Okay, I want to see if she is able or not to read the ball. Because to read is the most difficult thing. Okay.
This is the first thing that you check in when she coming to the gym?
Yes.
At what age?
13, 14, when they arrive. Usually I have girls that are almost 13, in between 12 and 13. Imagine is the finish of the age where they learn the motor skills. They did mini volley, they did all the pre-volley things, or they didn't, you don't know. Sometimes they arrive because the classmate say, oh, I go to play volleyball, comes with me and blah, and you will have every day one new girl. But you cannot know if some talent come inside your gym. So what you see? Usually, you see how they touch the ball, how they move feet, how they run, how they jump. One way to understand if someone is able to be a good middle blocker, to be a good blocker, is to understand how they read the ball. Doesn't need you put one set, you can invent one game. Okay, also with the blocked ball. But the capacity to move on the net and to react to the ball is one characteristic of the good middle blocker.
So this is the first role that you check. You check first, you're looking for a middle blocker, and then you look for it.
We are talking about block. So in this case, I'm saying what I check about block. Okay. In this age, I work in everything, okay? Not only in middle blocker. All the players work in set, in reception, in defense, in attack. It's not important to decide too early if you will be a middle blocker or a setter. But in your mind, as a coach, you start to understand, if someone can be a good middle blocker, a good setter, a good spiker, a good opposite, or a libero. Okay. So if I have a girl inside the gym that is very brave, that she wants to take the ball so much, it's a fighter, and it's very fast, maybe in my mind I start to think that maybe she could be a good libero. Okay, so now we are talking about block. So I put focus in this fundamental, okay? When we speak about block, in my mind, I have three keywords, okay? Where, when, and how. Where I jump, when I jump, and how I put the hands, how I jump, okay? And all these things are important when I start to work in the fundamental, because all these things can be the reason for one big mistake. I mean, all the mistakes we do in block are related with one of these things. Maybe I arrive in the right position, I jump in a good timing, but my hands are like this, and I take block out. Or I have a very good bouncing platform, I'm in perfect position, but in bad timing. So all the mistakes I can have inside the block are related with one of these three keywords. And I use these three keywords to help my player for the correction, to understand where they are making the mistake. So when, it means that, okay, wait, no? It's too early, you are jumping too early, you are jumping too late. Where, because if you don't jump in the right position, you fly away, the ball is short, you are in antenna, blah, 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 you are not blocking. And after, how you block. The quality of your platform, that is very important, okay? In these three keywords, we can build the two aspects of the block work, of the ski, of the fundamentals, the technical part and the tactical part. In the technical part, we will speak about the translations, how to move in the net, and about the bouncing platform, how you put your hands in the other side, okay? How you check the ball. About how the timing, it's technical, but it's also tactical, because it's something that is related also with the system, the block system, and so the defense system, because it's very complicated to speak about block system if you don't speak also about the defense system. It's something that is linked each other, and usually we speak block and defense system, usually, when we talk about systems. And when we talk about systems in block, we have three macro categories. The reading block, the option blocks, or the mixed situation. This, all these things are things that you have to teach your players starting from the first day. But in my mind, for example, in the young girls, I never teach option block. I work for a long time only in reading. Why? Because, as I said before, the most difficult thing is to read the ball and to react and to adapt. To take an option, it's very easy. I say to my player, go before there and jump. Don't care about the opposite, go in position four and jump. But this thing doesn't help to develop the quality, technical, tactical, and psychological quality of the player. So it's very easy to use option block when you play if you need, but in practice, I never use option block. I practice only reading block. Question?
Can you explain the difference between the reading, the option, and the mix?
Yes, absolutely. Okay, I start with reading. Okay, we say the reading is to read. I read one event. The event is the ball that goes out from the hands of the setter. I react to the ball. The ball leaves the hands of the setter, and I react. So idea is I'm running behind the ball. I try to be fast enough to arrive in the right position when the ball is spiked from the spiker. Okay, option, it's to take an option. I mean, I decide before to jump with the middle blocker. Doesn't matter what happened. I'm in front of the middle blocker, and when the middle blocker in the other side jumps, I jump. Maybe the setter set in four, and in this moment I can try to go down and react and try to arrive to block, or I have to do something different. And we are talking about block and defense system. Mixed is something that it's I mix in between option and reading. I mean, after studying the opponents, so data volley, statistics, and blah, 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 I know that in some situation, in the other side, it's very probable that the setter will do something, and I cannot choose. So I cannot take an advantage. For example, one step in right, two step in right, one step in left. I give you an example. Maybe some setter, every time that the ball is close to the net but moved in four, set in two, or set in four, or set the pipe. It's something that I know because I studied the opponent. So maybe I can take an advantage to take one step in the right direction. And after this step, when the setter is setting, I have to stay and read. Because it's true that maybe 70% of the time she set in two, but the rest she set in four. So I must be able also to react in the other direction. So it's something mixed in between option, because I take an advantage before, but it's not a blind option. I take an advantage and after I react.
Okay, I understand. Now we call it in a different name, so I didn't understand what it
was. How you call?
The option, we call it commit.
Commit, okay. Yes, yes. Okay, you can commit with different, you can commit with the middle blocker, you can commit with the opposite, with the position four, you can commit with the pipe. So you can decide that in some situation, for sure, you will take in block this player, okay? The only real commitment is with middle blocker. The primo tempo is the only real, because it's the only times when you have to jump for sure. And if the setter set in another direction, pray and try. Okay, for sure in this case there is a big difference in between girls and boys, especially in high level. Why? Because, okay, now the difference in between the speed of ball in girls, in women and men is not so big like before, but there is difference. So in women volleyball, you need to commit probably only if the ball is perfect in the end of the setter under the net. Because when the ball is 1 meter far, you cannot read in high level. With the men, maybe not, because the ball is fast, very fast, also when the ball is not perfect under the net. And so, okay, in this case, probably you need to take a decision also when the ball is not double plus. And this is the big difference, you know, in the tactical choice in between men and women. Okay. About translation. Okay. So I said the thing I train starting from a very young age, it's reading. And I start to put inside the tactical choice when the girl is under 16. I don't use tactical choice before. Okay, in the match, in the game, if I need to win and I have to steal 1-2 points when we are 23-23, okay. But in general, till the girls are under 16, I don't put inside tactical choice. Not in block, not in defense. For sure, not in practice. In the game, if I need for winning the game. Okay. For me, it's very important. I know that someone is for sure doesn't agree with me, but the thing is, for example, I want to do an example with defense. Okay. The system I use in defense from young to under 16 and more, it's 2-0-4, 2 in block, 0 in tip, and 4 in defense. I want that the player read the tip. You must be able to read from the line, take the spike, strong spike, and tip. Okay? And I never, never train the system with line closed and position 1 in tip. After, if in the game there is a player that makes a lot of tips and we are not able to take this tip in defense and I need to win the game, all in the game I say, okay, now girls, close the line and take tip before. But all in the game. Especially when they are very, very young. In block is the same. I want to block in reading. And my idea is block in reading and defense in reading. They have to develop the ability to read the ball and react.
If you don't practice on a situation like this, when you suddenly decide to close the line, they can do it in the game if you're not trainable.
Look, when the ball in these categories, the ball is very, very slow. If they are able to read, for sure it's very easy to close. When I say I don't practice, okay, probably I can practice reading with the closed line. Okay, I don't practice the idea to move 1 hour before to go in one side and close perfectly the block and jump. Okay, it's clear. They have to understand that if the ball is very far from the net and the setter set four arms, they move before. If the setter of the libero or one other player is obliged to set in one direction, I move before, but is not omitting. This is only the reading again, what is happening in the other side. I understand the game situation and I react to the game. And is the thing that I want to build in my player. The ability to react to the game, because volleyball is a situational game. Many different things happen during the game. I must be able to react, to adapt. I must be able to adapt and react with the things I learned in the gym. So, in my idea of volleyball, in my idea to build the players, is to give to my player the highest quantity possible of motor skills, technical skills, to react to different situations. They have to use, they have in the backpack, and when comes a new situation, they have to find in the backpack as fast as possible the right solution, also mixing two different skills. Because if you build one player that is able to react only if he knows the situation, it's a problem. It's like martial art. You go in the gym, you practice martial art, and you react perfectly when someone gives you one punch. Okay, after you are in the street and the criminal, instead to punch you like this, punch you like this, you are not able to react, you take the punch here. It's the same in volleyball. If they have a schema, a mental schema like this, and they react only to the things they know, it's very, very complicated to play one real game. It's not PlayStation. The other side, they are humans, they are real players. That maybe sometimes instead to spike, take the ball badly, and the ball is like a fluffy ball, blah, blah, blah. Every time the ball is down. Why? Why? Because you cannot to practice this. You cannot to practice every situation. Because some situation is something that happens once. So you practice the things that happen 80% of the times. But you have to practice, you have to teach the things that help your players to react to every situation. That doesn't mean that after the strange ball doesn't go down, for sure. In block, I teach the reading block, okay? And for sure, I teach all the technique of translation. And in my idea, I divide the technique of translation in two parts. The technique with cross step and the technique with side step. Side step are used for small distance or very fast ball. The cross steps are used for bigger distance and ball medium fast or slow. Okay. The most important technique in the side step is the technique with we call stiffness steps. It means double impulse step. That is, if you see the very high level volleyball, is the technique that is used 80% of the times from the high level middle blocker to block super ball or very fast ball when the ball is perfect on the net. Why? Because it's the very fast way to move on the net and it's the faster way to be frontal on the net and to show immediately the hands in the other side. Because in this technique, you have to move without going down with hands. You have to move with the hands here, and when you arrive, you immediately take the other side with hands forward. The stiffness, I would like to show you, I don't know how to do it because it's, you know, it's a bit complicated. But it's basically it's the technique where if you are this, you do one step, big step in the side, and after this big step, you rebound. So this foot, it's only the pivot foot, and you change and jump. I don't know if not, I try to turn the PC and show.
Maybe you try to show.
I try. I don't know if I can, but sorry, because let me see. I don't know.
It's okay.
Okay,
it's okay. Wait. Yes. Move the right.
Okay.
Perfect.
Okay. Idea is, okay, I'm in block. We said you don't see my hands, but after I told you the hands never goes down here, start in the line of the eyes, and from here go immediately up. Idea is I do one step in the side, so here step, and from here it's rebound. Step, rebound. Okay. If you do this well, you can take almost 3 meters or more, because the ability is to do very big first step, and after you have the jump. Imagine in high level, one tall middle blocker can take 3 meters, 3.5 meters. And against all the fast ball, I imagine 7 or quick in 4 or slide, if I don't remember bad, in you call Shuko, like this ball back for middle blocker. Slide, one step back for middle blocker. You can arrive to put your hands immediately in the other side. Especially because this kind of ball is not so high over the net. Okay. And you need just to show immediately the hands, to put hands on the other side and to close the angle. You must to oblige the spiker to open the angle and the spike in 4 meters. Okay. It's clear that when the ball is so fast, you cannot to think that middle, and you are reading that middle blocker will arrive perfectly in front of the spiker. You cannot to ask to your middle blocker, when you are playing against one setter that push a lot the ball, read and arrive perfectly here in the other side, no, with the hands. It's impossible. It's a request that it's impossible to do. So for sure, the system of block need to be built with this idea. When the ball is very fast, I arrive in position better is possible. And you need to teach from young, the secret is you have to arrive where you can arrive and go in the other side, straight on. Don't fly. My idea. I don't like the middle blocker that fly away to try to close the hole. I prefer to have one open block, then one block like this, because for the defense, if I know that the block is open, it's very easy for position 6 or 5 go in middle of the block in the hole. But if you fly, it's impossible to know how much you will fly. The space, the quantity of court that will be free over the block will be bigger and bigger. So it's better to have 2 blocks like this, position 2, a middle blocker like this, than to have this, or worse, this, position 2 that do something strange. My idea in block is to teach from beginning the girls to close the middle of the court. And in super, I prefer, if someone need to close the hole in middle, I prefer that it's the side player that close the middle block, not the middle blocker. Because if I close with side, line is free, but I know it's just about to take, to leave the line and to take a little bit more space in line. And when the ball is very, very fast, It's not so easy to spike line strong. Usually super, it's in the middle. You play super strong in the delay of the block. To spike line with a very fast ball, there is some player, for sure there is some player. But when the ball is very fast, it's not so easy. And for sure it's not so strong like the straight on ball. So my idea, it's rib, and don't do this. Stay where you arrive, jump, and if someone needs to close the hole, or leave the hole open, or the side player close the block. Okay? Immediately, I start to teach this when they are very young, 13 to 14 years old. They block in two, no. They learn how to move. They learn side step, stiff step, and they learn to play one-on-one, to catch the ball one-on-one, to be active with the hands one-on-one. In the week, you will work in block. Maybe you have, I don't know, 3-4 times per week. I work all the four times for 10 minutes, 5 minutes. One time I will work in the translation, one time I will work in rebound, one time I will work in another translation, or I will work in translation with two people, one time I will work in rebound with two people. So you need to repeat, repeat, repeat. If you have 4 weeks, your exocycle, 1 week you do the most important technique plus two. The second week you repeat the most important technique with another two. The third week you repeat, and like this, you hold every time the most important technique for you and change the other two. After 1 month, you did all the technique and you repeated during the week for 4 times the most important. Okay. The cross movement is the classical movement you see in all the players in the world. No? In a medium and medium high level or low level. Step, cross, jump, cross, step, jump, side step, cross, jump. All the combination you can have with one cross step, run, cross and jump. But usually you use this kind of technique when the ball is slow, you are in the middle of the net, you want to read the ball, it's off, and you want to cover all the net. I teach this, yes, it's a part of the technique I want to teach, the motor skills I want to teach. In the first 2-3 years, you build all the techniques. After, when they start to be stronger physically, everything change. It's for the girls arrive before. Oh, the boys, maybe you have to wait 1 year more, but everything change in like this, because they become taller, faster, stronger, with more coordination. And all the work you did before, and you say, oh, but I'm so frustrated because I don't see nothing, I worked a lot and they are not able to do well, this, this, this. In 1 second, they change totally. And they start to do much better the things they learned in the right moment. And this is the thing. Because there are some skills that you need to teach early. Because after, it's very, very difficult to teach. If someone learn a bad uh, approaching attack with the right in front. If they learn this when they are 10, 11, 12, after to change, it's very, very difficult. For this, I say, teach the right thing in the right moment. Motor skills must be taught when they are very young. Till 12 years old.
Lino, one question.
Yeah.
In the high level, central players use the side steps?
Use side steps, yes. Use stiffness step. The steps I showed before is a kind of side step, like an impulse step. And it's in a study we did, Luca did in with the World Championship of 2010. They saw that 80% of the times the high level middle blocker use this kind of step because the ball is too fast to use another kind of step. I mean when the ball is in the end of the set, right? Because when the ball is far, the high level middle blocker can arrive in block also taking a coffee before. I mean, when they have to read and react. And if you see the high level volleyball, how many times the side spikers, outside or opposite spikes with the block perfectly in front when the ball is in the end of the set? Never. Block it every time, or all 1-1, 1.5 with strange. After there is different ideas. For example, I see Bakif bank block, try every time to close. They fly to close. Bakif bank, you have, I don't know, Rasic, and before was, we are speaking about the best middle blocker in the world, and it's different. If you have a middle blocker 195, it's different. If you are you have a Podrashkan in block, it's different. I must to teach what they need to be able to find the personal technical adaptation and tactical adaptation when they will arrive in their level. Because also this is a important issue. I want to teach one specific technique, okay? And I have one performance model in my mind. So in attack, I want to teach my player to open the arm with the elbow over the like this, perfect, okay. I teach like this to everyone. But after, someone open the arm here, someone go down, turn and go. And you say, and you have two chance. First chance is to scream like a crazy and to work to obtain what you want. Second chance, and to be smart and to understand if this adaptation is because the player doesn't want to do what you want or because he cannot do what you want because of physical characteristics. For example, the shoulder and the back as a shape that doesn't allow to the player to open. If the adaptation of the player allow to the player to have a good quality of attack with a good efficiency, I don't touch the new technique. It's an adaptation. I don't say to the other players, look to your teammate and do the same. No. it's something that the player find alone. You teach the technique based in your performance model after the game and the life do what the nature do what you need to do, they need to do. They change alone, they adapt alone. The only thing is to understand if this adaptation they do is good or not.
Lino?
La puttana, la paglia. Sorta.